Geoff, you're a sports betting journalist covering everything from company earnings to betting trends to government legislation. First week of April, Ontario set to welcome more competitors when it comes to single game sports betting. When we take a look at the U.S. as a template, what did they get right? What can we learn from them?
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a pretty long and winding road to get to this point in Canada. For a long time, we had this prohibition against single game sports betting. So it forced gamblers to go with parlays only, where you have to pick the outcome of two or more events in order to win your full bet. But that all changed last summer when you had federal lawmakers pass a private members bill that legalized single game sports betting and allowed the provinces to conduct and manage it. And so that now is being included into an iGaming market, an internet gambling market that Ontario is preparing to launch in early April. That market will include sports betting. It will include internet casino style gambling. It'll include poker, things like that. And what that will allow companies to do is come in and offer those products. And so that is a big change from what had been the status quo in the provinces. So the provinces, they traditionally have allowed only their government-owned lottery and gaming corporations to offer online gambling. Ontario now is going with this different model, which has been in the works for several years, and is now going to regulate and allow a number of different companies to compete with each other and with Ontario Lottery and Gaming Corporation for this internet gambling business. And when it comes to what we've seen in the U.S., you're right. We have been able to watch that experiment play out in the U.S. Since 2018, when there was a Supreme Court decision that really unlocked the legal sports betting market down there. So now we've seen 30 states plus the District of Columbia at this point offering some kind of legal sports betting. And so what's happened there with that experience in the U.S. has, you know, Ontario regulators, federal lawmakers, they've been able to watch that. And the other part of it too is, what's happened in the U.S. has really affected the sports industry more broadly, because you had leagues who earlier on, in years past had been opponents to a broader legalization of sports betting, really getting on board with it. And that provided a bit of momentum to the process in Canada as well, to now see these, you know, past opponents getting on board with that process and, putting some wind in the sails of that single game sports betting legalization effort.
Let's just get into it in terms of, is it local sports? Is it international? Is it all sports? What's allowed? What's not allowed?
So Ontario will allow is a pretty broad assortment of sports that you'll be able to wager on. All the major professional sports, college sports, esports, even so video games that are being played competitively, you'll have a ton of different stuff to bet on and that you've already been able to bet on. So the main difference is that it's only been OLG up to this point that has been allowed to offer this kind of single game sports betting, which just only became legal in Canada again back in August. So OLG has had this sort of free run that it's now going to kind of come to an end, and it's going to have to compete with these other companies, which will be allowed to offer a ton of different things to bet on, including, you know, you could have wagered on the outcome of some of these Oscars categories last week. So you'll have things like that will come up in the future as well.
Give us an idea when it comes to, I guess, the rake and the percentage that the house takes from a bet. What do those numbers look like?
So those numbers will kind of vary depending on the event you're betting on and the likelihood of that actually coming to pass and being a winner. So typically when you look at, say, an NFL football game on a Sunday, let's say the Miami Dolphins are playing the Buffalo Bills, Miami is a 3.5 point underdog. So you see Miami plus 3.5, that's the point spread that would have to, you know, if Miami loses by only 3 points, that bet would be a winner, but attached to that will be the odds. And so the odds typically on something like that would be, I'll go by American odds. And so it'd be minus 110. And what minus 110 means is that you'd have to bet $110 to win $100 on that bet. And that extra 10 on there is basically the vig that you would pay to the sports book. So that's, you know, that's the traditional take that you would see from the books on some of that, but that would change, those odds would change depending on the type of bet you want to make. If it's a far less likely bet to hit, then you would see the odds move from maybe minus 110 to minus 105 to maybe plus 100. So you, something you would call even money. And then for some of the more exotic bets or ones that, you know, bookmakers are pretty confident aren't going to come through, you would see those plus odds go much further up. So it depends on what you're betting on, but there is that built in take by bookmakers to ensure that they're getting something out of it.
When you take a look at the bigger picture, the numbers on a bigger scale, how big of a business is this in Canada? What does it mean for Ontario? And I guess ultimately as a revenue stream for the government.
Right. So we've had a few estimates that have been bandied about as this process has gone on. You have the Canadian Gaming Association, which has said for some time that, you know, $14 billion is being wagered by Canadians with either gray market or black market websites and bookmakers. So this would be anything from, you know, organized crime to a website that's regulated offshore, everything in between, that sort of activity. So that's one of the estimates that they have. Ontario has also said that they see Ontarians spending around $1 billion a year on online gambling, and about 70% of that going to on sites that aren't regulated in Ontario, that it might be based offshore, might be based somewhere else. So that's kind of like the ballpark estimates we have right now to work with. As for what it's going to provide to the province, we'll have to wait and see. Right now, we're just still seeing the number of companies coming into the market that are expecting to participate in the market. And we've got more than a dozen at this point that have been approved by the regulator. We're expecting to see more of them. So depending on how successful they are, that would translate into success for the province. The tax rate is going to be, I believe, or not even the tax rate, just the split that the province would see of that, it has been reported to be around 20%. So depending on how much action those books take, that will really translate to how much the province can take away from it too.
Lastly, what are the limits to betting? What systems are in place so you don't bet the farm?
Don't bet the farm. Do not bet the farm at all. That is one thing that is really going to have to be impressed on people as this Ontario market opens up, because there's just going to be a much more widespread availability of online gambling. And people should really keep in mind that you should set budgets for yourself, ensure that you're not gambling beyond their means. And it's also going to be incumbent on the operators to ensure they have responsible gambling policies in place, that they're keeping an eye on their customers, and that those customers aren't overextending themselves or not betting brazenly that it's really raising red flags. And so there will be opportunities for Ontarians to set limits for their own betting through these sites. And that is something that they should really keep in mind going forward, because, betting is it's betting. It's not a sure thing. You should always remember to really practice responsible gambling when you can. And ensuring that you, if you're going to lose money, you're losing something that is not going to have a huge impact on your life.